KCRA3 is uncovering new information about a possible shakeup in the Cordova Parks and Recreation District. KCRA3's Lindsay Paolo is live at the district offices with the latest developments for us. Lindsay.
Well, Edie, in about 2 hours, the board of directors will be meeting here behind me in a closed-door session. They're going to be talking about the future of the district administrator. If he is dismissed, KCRA3 has learned it could cost taxpayers. Earlier today, we tried to talk with them about tonight's closed session. Only one item is listed: interim district administrator. We wanted to know why they may replace district administrator David Edmonds, seen here in an earlier interview. Only one board member talked with us on the record.
We have a closed session, and after that, the outcome of whatever is talked about, there'll be a small, brief decision that'll be put out there for the constituents to hear.
We tried to talk with Edmonds at his home today. He would not talk with us on the record. KCRA 3 reviewed Edmonds' employment contract. The board can dismiss him with or without cause. If they dismiss without cause, the district would have to pay 6 months' severance, $78,000 plus benefits. Cordova is one of the larger parks and rec districts in the region, serving 110,000 residents in Rancho Cordova and parts of Sacramento County, including Rosemont, Riviera East, Mather, Anatolia, and Gold River. It has an annual budget of $23 million, some of which is going to six capital improvement projects, including White Rock Park. Cordova Parks has 40 full-time employees, none of whom would talk with us about what's going on.
So again, that closed session special meeting starts tonight at 8 o'clock. We should know more after that meeting. As for David Edmonds, he told me today he does not plan to be here. Live in Rancho Cordova, Lindsay Paolo, KCRA 3 reports.
So Lindsay, watching this, I think the intriguing question is, why would the board want to replace Edmonds?
Yeah, that is the big question here, Edie. And remember, these are publicly elected board members representing about 110,000 people. They haven't answered that question as of yet, and they tell us it's because they can't. It's a personnel issue, and they can't, under the Brown Act, talk about things that they discuss in closed session. But they do have to announce if they take any action tonight.
And Lindsay, we'll be sure to stay on this story tonight. Thank you.